been talking about the power and authority of God, of Jesus. Well, actually, I have. I've been talking about the power and authority of God, of Jesus. And today is no different. I wish you were there. Were you there? Were you there when the woman that had been sick for 12 years spent all of her money with doctors for 12 years, lost all of her money with doctors for 12 years, and was no better after, I don't know, how many years you think? 12 years. Were you there when she touched his cloak? Just touched it. And she was healed from her illness. She wasn't even supposed to be there. She was supposed to be in quarantine. Were you there? Or were you there when Jairus' daughter was sick? And he begged Jesus to heal her. Well, she actually died, but were you there when Jesus rose her from the dead? So no one was there. Truman, you weren't even there? You just heard about it. You did hear about it, or you read about it, right? Or at least you heard about Jesus, and you believe in Jesus. Or at least you're here, and you're listening. There is a lot of power in believing in Jesus, in having faith in Jesus. It's interesting, the woman that touched Jesus' garment never met him before. Never met him before she touched him. And Jairus, he never met Jesus before the day that he begged him to help his dying daughter. The day she touched Jesus, the day that Jairus begged him, was the first time they met him. They had just heard about him, like you. But they reached out and asked him because they were desperate, in need of help. They believed, or at least they hoped, that Jesus had the power and the authority to help, and he did. This woman that was sick for 12 years, had her period for 12 years. According to the law and customs, she wasn't allowed to be around anyone, family, friends, the church. You've been through the COVID pandemic, right? You know what it's like not to be around family and friends and the church for a year, right? And it almost killed us. Imagine 12 years. When she's healed and Jesus feels the power go out from him, Jesus wants to know who touched him. Terrified, she comes and she tells him the whole truth. She tells him her whole story, including the fact that she shouldn't have been there. She should have not only not have touched him, she shouldn't even have been there in the crowd. So this was a huge step in faith. And keep in mind, she didn't know anything more about Jesus than you did. Actually, you know more about Jesus than she did. There is a lot of power in believing in Jesus, in having faith in Jesus. Jairus didn't know anything about Jesus, but he had heard about him, and he was desperate, On the way to the house, he heard she was already dead, but when Jesus said, "Don't worry," he kept out of faith. Being sick and separated from family and friends in the church is bad enough. I don't think there's anything worse than losing a son or a daughter. We all know too many parents, even one last week, that have lost their children. It's bad enough to lose a loved one, but children should not die before their parents. So Jairus is really desperate, and he puts his trust in Jesus. Jesus says she was just asleep, but it sure looked like he rose her from the dead. Jesus has power and authority over sickness, even over death. Faith can access that. Your faith, my faith, can access that. In these stories, Jesus not only heals, but gives life. He gives life to that dying girl and to the hemorrhaging woman. Jesus also gives that hemorrhaging woman an opportunity to give life herself again, where she couldn't do it for 12 years. And in her day, being able to have a child was even more of a big thing than it is today. There is a lot of power in believing in Jesus and having faith in Jesus. Would this be something that interests you? We think of ourselves as self-sufficient. We don't need anybody's help. We can do it on our own. In fact, we don't even like it when people help us. And if they do, we want to hurry up and pay them back. Somebody bought me lunch this week, and I'm thinking, so when can I buy them back? But when we face some of the challenges that this world throws at us, the whole truth comes out. In the musical Hamilton, there is a very interesting scene. Thomas Jefferson and James Madison are very frustrated at Alexander Hamilton because he gets everything he wants. And why is that? Well, because President George Washington is backing him. And then they sing this really cool song. It goes something like this. It must be nice, must be nice to have Washington on your side. It must be nice, must be nice to have Washington on your side. How much more nice is it to have Jesus on your side? There is a lot of power in believing.